So I see that our friend, the godless Cranium, is getting flack from his atheist peers again about being too nice, about being too civil when he has a guest on his show last Saturday. I didn't see the original comments, but I see him saying on Twitter, defending himself against the charges of, you know, you're just too easy on these people. Then I look and Shannon, his co-host, mind you, on Saturday nights, is interviewing Psy 10 Brugenkate on her channel last night. And I see one of the comments, somebody goes, well, he really won that debate. And I was like, okay. You know, I think I know Shannon well enough at this point to say with pretty much complete conviction that I don't think she saw it as a contest. I don't think she saw it as her goal was to beat the guest that she had on the show. That's just not how these two operate. I can't speak with absolute certainty as to what they were trying to accomplish on Saturday, but my guess is if they got somebody on the show who has a completely different worldview from them, you know, they consider it more their goal or their duty or their agenda to try and figure out what makes that person tick. Not necessarily to shut that person down or get in that person's face. And just so you know, if you're an atheist, it is not an indication that you are really, really confident in your position if you feel a need to get up in somebody's face. Matter of fact, that is a sign of the opposite. If you're confident in your position, or you're confident that you believe your beliefs, you're not really all defensive about it. You know, that's one of the reasons why we can have, or I can have honest conversations with people like Shannon or the Godless Cranium, or even Little Drew, you know, because they're actually confident in what they believe, and they are confident in their position. Hence, they feel no need when they have a Christian on this show to shut him down or get up in his face or make sure that gets addressed. You know, they take it as an article of faith. Yeah, I know that word. I hate that word too. I hate that word. I hate that word. I know. We both hate the word. But they take it as an article of faith that the people in their audience are actually intelligent enough to draw their own conclusions. You know, I don't think Shannon felt any need to challenge Psy 10 Brugenkate. I don't think she agrees with a single word that came out of his mouth. And I don't think anybody in the audience did either. But all she was doing was letting him, you know, reveal himself and reveal the depths of his beliefs and the depths of his conviction. And if I know her well enough, I think she was just tripped out by it. You know, she just wanted to see what made him tick. She just was trying to, like, investigate for her own edification as well as for the edification of the audience. Now, I was going to have the Godless Cranium on my show this morning. And we had some tough technical difficulties. I believe I got it all worked out. But we'll see. Hopefully I'll get him on my show next week. But it's, you know, I will tear him a new one. Don't get me wrong. I will. But once I'm done with that, that'll be just a small part of the show. Yeah, I'll tear into him with everything I got. Both guns blazing. But once I'm done with that part of the show, then I'm going to really try and find out what makes him tick. You know, I wasn't quite satisfied the first time we sat down with him, Stephanie and I. I'm more curious as to how he arrived at the conclusions that he arrived at in life. I don't really feel it's my mission to try and challenge his beliefs. I know what he believes. You know, we don't agree. That's pretty much crystal clear. I'm pretty sure he knows where I stand on the subject, too. So I don't see it as my goal to try. I'm making fun of the fact that I'm going to dismantle him or demolish him, but I don't actually see that as anything on the table as to what I want to accomplish when I'm talking to him. And I don't think that that's how they operate either. My goal when I have an atheist on my show is going to be to try and find out what makes the person tick, especially if it's somebody like Godless Cranium, who I consider a relatively intelligent human being who is fairly hardcore committed to his cause. I mean, he's not just an atheist, he's also putting out videos and he's, you know, he's really, really committed to his anti-theist agenda. So my goal, and I'm sure this isn't that dissimilar from Shannon's goal when she had Psy 10 on the program, is to try and find out what makes him tick, try to make him feel comfortable and at home in the house of Craig, make him, you know, make a guest of him, break bread with him, say, okay, you know, tell me your terrible beliefs and how you came about them, and then we take it from there. So, if you are one of those atheists who are, you know, criticizing the godless Cranium for not being hardcore or aggressive enough with his guests, the criticism's not really that valid. It's really not. I don't think that that's their goal. I don't think that's their agenda. I don't think that's what they are about. There are other atheists out there, if that's your thing, you know. There are people out there who are combat morning, noon, and night. But I don't find those people particularly persuasive. And I don't think those people are particularly strong in their positions. Like I said, it's not an indication that you are strong in your position if you feel need to get up in somebody's face. It is actually an indication of its opposite. You'll find that I myself consider myself a really, really committed Christian. And I'm not defensive about it at all, as far as I know. The only time I get defensive, people are being a dick to me. But, you know, that doesn't happen with those two. So, being strong in your position, being committed to your cause, being convinced of your beliefs, doesn't tend to make you more aggressive. Should make you less. Should actually make you, you know, let's chill and talk. And you believe whatever thing you want to believe, and we'll try and get to the truth of the matter. Now, as far as I can tell, I think that's what he's about. And I think that that is the correct way to be about whatever it is you do in life. Because that is a more righteous approach to just life in general. Just disagreements in general. So that's my take on the subject, and we'll see. Hopefully I'll get him on the show sometime next week. I don't know, he's got a busy work schedule. And then we will take it from there. Amen.